Number one here, we got Alfie and King Burst. Oh, this man's rocking the New York Mets hat. I'm appreciating him already.
All right, King Burst, King Arc. I'm seeing a pattern with this Mega Man.
Oh, okay. All right, I was like, wait, that's not King Burst. Oh, gotcha, gotcha. All right, so Alfie rolling with the Palutena. You know, Palutena having the Reflector as an option in this, but also having those short hop nairs to really keep Mega Man grounded. Thing is, though, if Burst plays the way he's playing, consistently just staying back far enough with
it's
the pellets,
gonna be tough.
Yeah, it's going to be very annoying to deal with.
Palu does have the fact that she is good at against heavies like, in her favor. You know, Mega Man's not going to really be able to like get out of her combos once he's getting hit. But the thing is, can Alfie actually get these hits?
Yeah, that's the thing. Like King Burst is going to play the long game trying to rack it up slowly. But if you get one anti-air nair, then all of a sudden you get a high percent and you're back to even. But King Burst playing really well, except for just getting hit by the fair into the dash attack, even in right back up.
I'm liking his uses of Leaf Shield as like a kind of like a get off me option to land, which makes it actually super safe because as soon as if they're trying to go for something, they're just gonna get like kind of like smacked by Leaf Shield.
Exactly, and it makes you have to respect the mix up too. It's like, all right, he's gonna land with Leaf Shield this time. I have to hold Shield. Then King Burst decides to go for Tomahawk instead and gets a free grab. That's the layering that you have to do. But Leaf Shield in general is just such a good option to land with, and you see Burst consistently going for it. Gets a trade with the back air against Alfie's. Not going to die just yet, and going to roll his way out of that back throw.
Yeah, no, because at this moment, now the question is, who's going to take the first stop? Who's going to put themselves in that position to say, hey, I have the lead, now you have to come to me. And Alfie is praying that it is not King Burst.
Exactly.
Because Mega Man went the lead. Oh, my God.
Yeah, that is such a huge thing when it comes to pace control matchups. Both of these players want to have the other person overcommitting and coming in and trying to get in and taking so much damage. Good cancel away with that side B so he wouldn't get hit by the explosive flame. What's the landing option? No, good to actually get away from the up tilt.
Alfie trying to actually just go in with find an opening for the back end, but unfortunately, looks like King Burst.
Yeah, King Burst was the one able to get the cross out back here there, but doesn't matter. You're not getting yourself back to the stage. This belongs to me. Explosive Flame is going to go ahead and take that stock out.
And we're back to square one.
Man, we're already at the 4:40 mark. Two stocks down, one stock piece. I think we're probably in for a long haul on this one.
Oh yeah, definitely. But the thing about Palutena is that she can't be so explosive. Mm-hmm. And I do see that Alfie is trying to create these opportunities for himself where he's trying to find these backers that can lean into something different. But King Burst is doing such a good job of holding this Lemon Wall and Metal Blade and Leaf Shield. Wall.
And the Leaf Shield has been such a huge thing because Burst has recognized that a lot of these air-to-airs, he's just been putting Leaf Shield out and Alfie's been getting hit by them. Like, there's
every
been no rising
time.
Nair in yeah. those positions that has made him need to respect it. Like, all right, I will keep doing the Leaf Shield and you'll just keep getting hit by it. I'm going to win the long run.
As you say that, he literally just does it again. Mm-hmm.
See, right there again, nothing. He didn't back off. He didn't have any thing to call it out or an out smash. I'm sure as the match progresses, Alfie's going to recognize that. But right now, King Burst taking full advantage of it.
Yeah, and I know that if you're Alfie at this moment, you're thinking to yourself, why do I keep on getting hit by this? Why do I keep on getting hit by this? And I do want to see him make that adaptation very, very quickly, or else the set is not going to look good for him.
Oh, good defense from him there, too, because y'all Burst looking for that jump to get that back air. Yeah, he's consistently gone for some solid ledge traps. He just hasn't been able to close the stock out.
Okay, I like the down to, ooh, unfortunately not following up.
Yeah, having Rush to get yourself out of there and in the very scary situation. We saw what Frozen was able to do earlier with the ledge traps. But finally, a rising there. He's not going to die just yet, though. Very heavy character is Mega Man.
But I do see that Alfie is making some changes. And the fact that now when Mega Man's in the air, Alfie's actually going in with up airs. Mm-hmm. Oh, he got stuck by the Crash Bomber.
Using the neutral getup invincibility to prevent himself from getting followed up, he might have actually been able to bait. I mean, it was a very, very reckless play. But if he was able to bait Alfie to go for like a dash attack, well, he was able to close it out with that back air instead. I like the mindset on Burst.
148%, he wants extra credit at this point, right? Because I mean it's pretty obvious, but it's true. Mm-hmm. At this point, if you're Mega Man and you have the lead, you know,
he wasn't really able to get
approach?
Any on the last stock too. Like the stock was closed out immediately, and dash attack still not doing it yet either. Some mix between some good DI as well as just the survivability of Mega Man living at 169 against Palu, not something a lot of characters can also say.
He needs to be careful by getting back thrown at the ledge or back aired mid-stage.
Yeah, getting, you know, throwing out all those pellets. Eventually, he could get a trade with it, but that time just getting smacked in the face with the shield instead. You know, we're back to a dead-even game here. Currently looking at the two-minute mark.
Great fares. Once again, Burst creating this insurmountable wall for Alfie, and slowly, Alfie is just losing control of this match.
Yeah, and a lot of it, I think a lot of this extra defensive play having to do with the fact that this is losing. Ooh. That fourth smash getting him with the teleport on center stage. I like these saw blades he keeps putting out trying to catch him after the, you know, lingering through with the teleport is a very punishable window.
Hey, Alfie trying to just drop in fair, drop in nair, but unfortunately not doing it. This is what I'm talking about. He needs to get these nair strings because this is what this is. Oh,
that would be the last thing you want to see in SD out of it. But he still had rush online. He was able to get himself back. What? You know, he's just fading back. He's not committing to the ledge chat because he doesn't want to get forced off stage. But you're right. He has a nice lead here. Doesn't need to commit. Oh, but he's getting forced off stage here.
Oh, my God.
Oh, no!
Pineapple!
That and Kingverse definitely feeling that one a bit, you know. After what was such a long fought set, I just said prior, you don't want to ever see like an SD happen with something like this.
Yeah, not after all that, man. That's a lot of work. And we did see he tried to air dodge up and use that small drift to make it back, but unfortunately, he did mess up his recovery on that.
You see a lot of times people will try to get themselves within range so they don't get hit by the drop off nair from Palutena. But and you see that just the fact that Alfie ran off stage forced him to go low. He didn't stay on stage because Alfie just could have recovered to ledge. He made him go under, and that ended up leading to that.
Sometimes you just have to be there for pressure.
Yeah,
you know?
Like there's an SD, and then there's a forced situation that led to it. Mm-hmm. And that sometimes is kind of left behind in the thought process of the things that went wrong. And luckily for Alfie, he was able to walk on top of it because he was definitely getting, he was having a hard time getting
schmixed
in at the end there. Yeah.
He was getting schmixed is the proper term. Okay, but we are on Kalos now, so let's see if the kind of like split of the platforms can help Alfie kind of just turn the match in his favor.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, as you know, King Burst already having 82% on him, so Alfie, this match is going a bit different than we did before.
I think a part of the stage choice here, for one, I mean this stage definitely benefits Mega Man for sure, but I think a little bit more survivability off of those back airs. You know, that was pretty much a consistent kill confirm that Burst went for. Never really gotten up till off of Alfie at any point, so doesn't really need to worry about killing off the top.
Great farewell. And here starts the walling, Ajax. Here starts the walling.
Yep, exactly what we anticipated. You know, Burst trying to find his way back over to the other side so he could just slowly rack up this damage. But Alfie keeping it very even, looking much better so far in this game number two.
And one thing that I want to see from Alfie is a mixture of his explosive flames. He's kind of just using them in a very predictable manner, where as soon as he's off stage, boom, explosive flames.
I think the big thing I want to see out of Alfie is just punish some of these leaf shields. Like, it's very hard to punish, but fade
That's
back,
what I
bait
want to
him
see.
To come nice. In, and then use something like an explosive flame or an up smash to get him to stop doing that, because he's taking so much damage because of it.
Yeah, he's not punishing these leaf shields at all. And while it's maybe just 1% or 2% here and there, it is racking up, and eventually it will mean something.
You know, it's people kind of turn down the importance of salt-inducing moves. Like, when you're making your opponent get frustrated because they're getting really mad at always getting hit by these projectiles, like, it forces them to come in closer. But trying
Great
to commit
down smash.
To an up smash gets punished himself by the down smash. Alfie taking the lead.
And keep it. Oh! Ooh. Metal Blade into up smash. Okay.
Yeah,
okay, Burst, I see you.
Yeah, getting that confirmed where he needed it. And yet again, but both of them, you don't usually see the leads being too far off. The stocks are taken right away after the first one.
Oh, yeah, this match is close. It's not one-sided by any means. But here and there, the little interactions that keep on happening are what makes it's what makes a difference in any set, you know?
Exactly. You know, every little bit, as long as you're conditioning along the way, even with a character that has somewhat a simpler design in terms of what you're going for with, like, a Palutena, where you're just trying to go for those nairs, you're trying to go for the zoning attempts and make your opponent come to you, you still have to be capable of making people do that. And Burst has not had too many times where he's felt, like, a necessary need to overcommit and go in on him. He just keeps getting in with the leaf shields.
Yeah, and that's the thing.
Oh! Ooh, excuse me, no fly zone. This is mine.
Right? I do like the attempt, though, you know, because he did notice that Alfie switched it up, and Alfie is actually going in for those up airs. Mm-hmm. And so he's like, you know what? If you're going to attack me aggressively in the air, I'm just going to down air spike the hell out of you.
Yeah, I'm actually feeling pretty happy about the fact that you just saw that parry come in from Alfie on that leaf shield. It's like, all right, maybe he's starting to get a little bit more familiar with how the timing is on it. Meanwhile, Burst still staying consistent with his landings as well. A lot of these dares and B reverses on the leaf shield, keeping himself safe, not really being stuck in Alfie's comfort zone. Oh, there you go. Gets the saw blade into confirm. That's going to be a kill.
Hey, and once again, we're in the same situation as last game. King Burst with the lead and just chipping away at Alfie's health. Great fair, but he needs to be able to put him in a situation. I like the down air two frame. Up there, he's going to do it and immediately takes a stock. Alfie, 16%.
Yeah, getting the anti air with that up air was very important. Not having to face a large deficit like he did in that last set, or excuse me, the last match. That match did end up going in Alfie's favor due to that SD situation that he had. But can Alfie just close it out outright? Will Burst going to get eliminated from the tournament?
Yeah, no, and we're going to see, man. Remember, loser of this is eliminated. And here we go with the Nair train.
Yeah, keeping it back dead even here, trying to catch him on a jump. And you see that Alfie's starting to catch the fact that he's going for a lot of these anti.
Yeah.
There you go. Now he's starting to punish a lot more of these leaf shields. And look at the difference it's making because of the fact that he's doing so.
And the amount of confidence that he had to just go all the way up there and go for that up air. And if King Burst would have got hit, that was it.
Yeah, and
he
now it's on King Burst to change that up. It's like, all right, now he's finally caught me on this. I have to change my game plan drastically because I need to start maybe Tomahawk landing or maybe hold shield to bait out the Nairs so I can punish him on his jump. It's so important to change now because otherwise he's going to get eliminated.
Mm-hmm. I would have gotten away with it if it weren't for you meddling kids.
That dumb Nair.
But now you see he's actually retreating with these up airs, hoping to catch Alfie, because Alfie keeps on jumping in. That's literally, he just always keeps on jumping
in. You see,
in.
Alfie's kind of gotten a hold of what he's looking for on the anti airs now, too. We were just talking about with him staying grounded, he just punished him with that back air. Very good adjustment to F tilt, not going to kill just yet. Trying to go for the two frame at the ledge as well. Alfie's starting to take a bit of damage on the way back up, though. Like, this is not in any way, shape, or form done yet. You see King Burst.
Oh, he needs to be careful because that Mega Man's bear and fair do kill. Yeet!
Not yet. No, the wide blast zones of Kalos are going to come in clutch where he needed it most.
Oh, no. Oh, no, Alfie. Not like this. Okay, King Burst doing a great job. Oh, my God.
You know, I think that was a mix-up of two things. One, he definitely just got
caught. The DI was sus.
Yeah, he was going to the left with that roll, and he's already committing to run the other way. So the DI definitely assisted in that kill, but also got called out on the roll. So that was a great call from Alfie there. Kind of stealing away that first game and able to take the second game, mostly because of his adjustments at the end, particularly around the air-to-air game. You saw how he got out of there quick, fast, and in a hurry.
That was so heartbreaking, man.
Hey, you saw the look on Burst's face afterwards.
He knew.
Definitely one that you're going to have to go back and watch, like, all right, I got caught. Man, Helper really likes